Next minutes, I'll take you through a short journey from the bigger problem to Velux, the solution, as I may say, maybe. If we do nothing, who does? It starts with us. It's a picture not in Europe, it's Sao Paulo, which is the problem we are standing for. It's already said, in 2050 there are 9 billion people living on this planet, with almost 17% in the cities. Nowadays it's 55%. And there's another problem we have to face. We're eating our planet. Somebody knows Earth Overshoot Day? It's the date on which we, as people here, consume more than the planet Earth can produce in 1 year. And last year, 2019, it was the end of July. And in the last 20 years, it moved up the calendar by 2 months. Now, look at India, look at Brazil, look at China, what they're doing. So it's becoming bigger, bigger, bigger problem. The air quality in the cities is very poor at the moment. It's not becoming better. Also, the traffic jams and the accessibility in the city is a big problem. Also in Holland, but also in Paris, and I was in Florence last weekend, also a big problem. It's becoming more. This view is normal at the moment in Holland. I don't know if it's here in Paris is a normal picture, but in Holland it's becoming normal. Heavy rains, climate change, heat stress in the cities, it's becoming normal. 2015, the UN Nations, the United Nations made up the Sustainable Development Goals, 17 specific individual goals which have to be connected, and they were embraced by the UN member states, and each goal should be achieved in 2030. There's a lot to do, and there are more goals than I showed in the pictures here before. It's also about poverty, it's about loneliness, it's about climate action. No, you can read it. But it's more becoming more important for companies like us, like Heijmans, to embrace these development goals and put them in our strategy. Last year we worked very hard on a new strategy, and it's based on healthy environments. We have impact in the Netherlands. We build a lot of environments and building in it, and we can do something good. Before it was all about sustainability, and we moved to healthiness. So it's now about creating healthy environments, and we put some elements in it. It's about energy, it's about materials, it's about mobility, it's about biodiversity, but one of the most, I think, myself, is the social component. But you can make nice buildings, but when the people who work or live in it are not happy, it's the wrong building. And the same with public space. So we, to subscribe this ambition, we made some bold statements, and we write them down in our annual report last year. So that was a big step for us to write them down. Some of them are standing here. So we want to go there and come there in 2023. I now want like to go with you to the healthy house. This is a smaller part of the building environment, but I go there in steps. And this is, in my opinion, what's happening. We had houses, we made new houses, but they are so bad that we have to put in lots of installations to ensure we can live in them. It's very ridiculous. So where we want to go is, we want to go there. Less installations, more healthy inside climate. At the moment we are working hard on a couple of home innovations, and they're connected to the themes I mentioned before, as material, energy, health, you can mention them. But we're working hard on them to make the home smarter, And I told you before, with new sensoring, collecting of data, we try to connect all these themes together to ensure and to measure that we can make healthy homes. We want to put them together in a concept house. We call it a bright house, and it has to be an awesome house, like Tesla is an awesome car. The bright house is an awesome house you want to live in. It's about all the aspects. And here you see a section of it. It's about fresh air. It's about green with a function of heat stress, rain adaptation, the light, ventilation, energy, all aspects you have to put in that healthy home. But also our house automation. For over more than 4 years, we already put in our houses house automation. It's easier for the consumer, easy to use, and we get a lot of data out of it, so we can improve our homes, we can measure, and we can make them better. This picture I'm very proud of. It's a competition we have won this week in Utrecht. It's a new building. It's kind of a Maya temple, I call it. There's a lot of green in it. It's stick with biodiversity, climate adaptation. It's energy neutral. And as 150 apartments for all kind of social groups. This from very small to very big. These kind of plans we make, we develop, and we build them. This is another example we're working hard on last years. It's working on materials. This is the Heijmans one. He knows him. It's a tiny apartment, a tiny house, I have to say. It's two. Exists of two parts. It's energy neutral. It's almost circular. And you can move it in one day from the one place to another place. At the moment, we have sold about 350 of these Heijmans ones, and only in the Netherlands. But we can't do this alone. We need new partnerships. We need pilots. We need, as we call it, urban living labs, to experiment, to learn, and to develop, and to bring it into our new developments. It's interesting. It gives you energy. You are connected with new partners inside the branch, outside the branch, science. Google, you can name it. Altogether, we have to make new innovations to ensure we can make healthy homes. Last summer, we went to a demolition company in the Netherlands. They take wood from old buildings, they ship it to Denmark, and there they make beautiful new roof glasses from it. And we put them in our houses, so it's a circular product from Velux, and we're the first in Netherlands to do this. So maybe it's for Spain or other countries also profitable. I like to end to say, and if we want to live on this planet in the cities together, we have to make healthy homes. And we have to do it together, so we need new partnerships, and we have to start acting now and not wait. Thank you.
Oops, sorry.